Not good. They were not pretty. Nahas would not be happy.
Okay.
All right, gentlemen. Looks like we got a draft for game number two of our final series today. Dame number one of the Starladder I-League Invitational. It's Secret vs. Complexity with Secret up one game. And this is what we have been waiting for this whole moment, gentlemen. The first phase. Drow. Is she going? Is she staying here? Complexity.
Complexity won't be in it.
Maybe they want it. Yeah.
They got first pick. Are they going to hold out for it? Are they going to hope for something else?
I think ET maybe might be worthy of a ban here.
Beastmaster. Oh, that's it. No Drow.
Why did they ban it?
We're done.
I guess they just don't feel comfortable playing with it. That must be, it has to be that.
What team doesn't feel comfortable playing with Drow Ranger?
Complexity,
I'm just telling
maybe
you
they
what
feel,
it is, man.
Maybe they're like, you know what? If any team has something in their pocket for a Drow, it might be Secret. We don't want to do that now, so good day, sir. We'll ban the Drow.
It just it feels right now a little bit like at TI with C-Deck and the Leshrac. Like, you have to be able to run this hero. If Drow is going to remain...
They've definitely run it before, though, and with high success, so
So you don't think they're uncomfortable?
I think it's more so what he says, like, maybe Puppy has something against it. Like, they expect us to first pick it, so we'll go with something different.
They go back for the Beastmaster, though.
But then you're mind-gaming yourself.
Yeah, then you're at a draft loss, which is never a good thing, but...
Now, here's the big question mark of the draft, though, is now what Secret do with this.
Definitely,
Elder Titan,
Elder
Shadow Demon.
Shadow Demon, no surprise, versus the Beastmaster, and also... Just because the rise of Shadow Demons, apparently, is now the thing.
He's a thing now. If you didn't like him before, too damn bad.
I mean, Secret were running Elder Titan when nobody else was. That was the old incarnation with, was that the Fly No-Tail Secret, I think, that was running Elder Titan quite a lot?
Yes, that was with, Puppy was playing Crystal Maiden a lot, and No-Tail was playing the Elder Titan pretty much every single game. I think that was Summit 3?
3?
Was it?
3?
God,
that's
when
Secret
won. There's been so many Secrets at this point. This is Secret 4.0, right? This is 4.0?
I think so. I think we saw Starladder first, though.
Oh, you're right, we did see it Starladder first. And
6 or 7 or something?
Yeah.
Well, they do get their IO, so good call there, Dakota.
Yeah, you know, Complexity, they're looking to come back into what we call the comfort picks here.
Yeah.
They're like, the last time, they seem like a very team that, you know, and it was mentioned coming into the series, they like to crack the code. They've done their research on the other team. They feel like they'll have the answer, but maybe every once in a while you just be like, you know, we'll do our game. Maybe that's what Complexity are going to be looking to do here for game two, game.
Wisp with Beastmaster in general is just nice because you have the Roar for easy setups for whatever partner the Wisp is with.
What's a Timberband?
I think that would have been great for them. I think they would have loved to have Timber actually on the side of Secret. But,
they banned it 5th last game as well, but 3rd ban.
Very...
Well, they already have both of their supports, and they don't really have much lockdown at this point.
Are they not going to ban Murano?
Shadow Demon's quite good versus Timbersaw, though. Soulcatchers.
Yeah, but they don't have, like, any control.
No, really.
No silences, no stuns. I mean, I guess you have the stomp, but it's not super reliable.
Yeah.
It's interesting they ban it, though. It really would be good versus those heroes.
Do Secret need to consider top Wisp candidates here? Do you take out the comfort Limp Tiny at this point? Do you think it's even worth the bans?
Shadow Demon's pretty good versus him. Like, he gets kited, like so hard. Purge.
That's true.
It's very hard to play against the Shadow Demon, I think, especially with the farm discrepancy that we had last game. But this game,
plus
maybe should do a little better.
Yeah, plus having those illusions with Disruption would probably be pretty sweet, especially if later on he has, like, AC and stuff like that.
Do you ban Luna? The other big Shadow Demon.
I think you
ban
Murana. Murana's like a much bigger deal than Shadow Demon.
And it just seems like that's what we've been seeing, like, everybody using more.
Luna's annoying, but it's, like, not that bad when you have Beastmaster and IO.
Do we get a trusty Bulba pick for the offlane here for Secret? They're a team that likes to hold on to those cores.
The old school Bulba Elder Titan mid. Is that coming back?
God, when that hero was mid every game.
That was so...
Astral just gave you like +200 damage.
Well, you you one-shotted the range creep with the Astral and the max Astral order, so the lane would just push like super hard.
Thank God that's not a thing anymore.
I think they could just give them Tide again. Tide's good versus Wisp, it's good versus Tiny. If they want to pick it up, it's good versus Beastmaster, and why not?
It's safe. It doesn't really reveal anything else either. Just kind of putting it out there. Tide's decent.
Bat's okay too, I think. But not as strong as Titan.
These are boring offlaners, though.
Alright, what would spice your night up, Dakota?
Bring back that NA influence and throw Enchantress in the offlane, though. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, God, no.
Please don't. No.
These are solid options, though, gentlemen, I agree. With Tidehunter still out there to be your big gun, your big initiator, and then, of course, the Batrider to set it up. Well, Tide has been snagged up by Secret, so they'll take that. Leaves the Batrider as the other...
I'm getting a little tired of seeing a Bulba Darkseer Tidehunter every game, guys. I'm not going to lie.
Why not, right?
Nice and stable.
I want to see that clockwork.
It's super consistent and good.
No, I mean, it's working. Can't argue with results.
Yeah.
Makes me sad.
Clockwork's just situational at best.
Yeah. Disastrous at worst.
Or a support.
I'd like to see Bristle, actually, for complexity. I think they play really well around. I also think it's pretty good versus Secret's lineup.
We go for Dazzle.
Dazzle again.
Dazzle again, yeah. Interesting. Maybe they're setting up for some type of pseudo aggro.
With Wisp? Pseudo aggro? X?
Like dual? Dual maybe rotations? Yeah, potential.
I don't think that safe one's particularly weak, though.
It's not.
Yeah.
All right, Korax from Secret. Here we go. The murmurs are real.
Who would play it? I don't really see or TZ playing it.
That's an interesting Ursa pick, actually.
It really is.
Shadow Demon, Ursa, two probably like the strongest laners, actually, together. Ursa, of course, gives them the Roche potential, the obvious, but...
They picked it kind of early compared to most teams, though. Like, usually when you see the Ursa pick, it's like they'll have some like melee core that Ursa just really shuts down in 1v1s, or at least like a hero that he dominates, but they have Roar, they have the Boar, they have the move speed of the Io to help deal with him.
Yeah, they have a lot of different factors to deal with the Ursa. Maybe because Ursa's very good versus Tide, maybe that they thought Complexity could have been expecting it, right? Maybe like a slight deny pick?
That's probably the most reasonable.
The most thing I could think about.
We're just used to seeing him as like a fifth pick or like a counter pick, as opposed to just like, we just want to run Ursa and we think he's good this game, but gives them great Roshan potential, obviously.
Yeah, the best reason I could at least think is the deny pick because of Fury Swipes versus Tidehunter. It doesn't work for Anchor Smash, but or a Kraken and Anchor.
Yeah, or just Roche potential.
Yeah, or they want a Roshan hero and they just like this hero in general.
I mean, Dazzle Io, is there any consideration for Huskar or does the Ursa shut that down too hard?
I think the Ursa shuts that down.
That may have been also a part of the reason why they went with the Ursa. Do you think that Complexity's Huskar could have been inbound and they wanted to get something to...
I mean, it looks like some mega carry with the Io Dazzle. Like, they want that one super beefy, like, frontline bruiser.
I think Shadow Demon's really good versus that, though.
Yeah.
Like, you kite him for, like, 5 seconds minimum, I think, with those two spells, regardless of whether or not there's a Wisp. So, and then Tidehunter takes out most of the strength ones.
I mean, they also like Tiny a lot as well. Ursa, quite good against Tiny as well.
So what do you have to get now that Secret have shown their ace of Ursa pick?
I'm trying to think combos to be very good with the Wisp, but...
I don't even think Bristle's particularly good with
Ursa. Yeah, they go for the Huskar.
Nicely done.
All right.
Was it the best choice, though, is the thing.
I mean, it's still a great supporting cast for a Huskar, but... I do think Shadow Demon and Ursa are quite good against him.
And, I mean, Soulcatcher plus Astral into Berserker Blood, it's not a huge detriment, but it does help to boost the magic damage. But Team Secret doesn't really even have much magic damage. They just have, like, a couple different throwaway spells.
And now we look to the potential mid lane now for
Secret
both
needs something to kill towers. They really have no... like siege potential right now.
Yeah, that is something that they're lacking. Someone to bring together their five men.
Well, they have Death Prophet and DK still in the pool. If you're looking at push potential.
Yeah, I think something along those lines would work. They have the Shadow Demon.
Shadow Fiend.
I would actually not be surprised if Secret picked Pugna too. They ran a decent amount with Elder Titan.
I also think that's true.
Like, it's a good tower hitter, and it's also, I think, pretty good versus Huskar.
Yeah, you get the free Ghost Scepter, man.
Yeah, and you can just cast on him. He's, like, kind of useless.
And there's been buffs to that Decrepify many a time. You can do it on allies. It doesn't reduce their speed anymore. Like,
that hero is
there.
That hero has gotten an ungodly amount of buffs.
Yeah, he's just one of those sleeper heroes, you know? Like,
it's like the pre-TI2 Morphling where he just kept getting buffed and buffed.
And suddenly
buffed.
One team is like, we should try this guy out.
Suddenly he's the hardest carry in the game that solos mid and wins every matchup. Pugna's maybe not going to be the hardest carry in the game, but he'll get to that point eventually.
Pugna's pretty, if you've played versus it, it's pretty ridiculous, but you're just still a Pugna. You're just so squishy. You're so position based, but
is still bad.
Yeah, you deal the most damage in the game once you get your items, so it's ridiculous.
Reduce the cooldown, I believe, on his blast. It's like every 5 seconds he's
he's great against
Fury.
His carry Naga.
Eat all the illusions.
Life drain the illusions. Yeah, Fnatic did, or I think it was they were Titan at the time.
I thought we would see that when Terror Blade was coming back. I thought we'd see some Rise of the Pugnas.
Rise of the Pugnas.
Because it's the same thing.
Not scary army at all.
He sunders, and then you decrepify, and you just life drain him, and you literally gain all your health back almost instantly in the time of that. So it's pretty interesting. But enough of Pugna.
Then he gets hit with a finger from Lion, and he's dead.
Well, this is a hero that is great at kiting Ursa. The Weaver now picked up.
So who's mid?
But they're very frail here.
Huskar West mid, I guess?
Yeah.
Okay.
So well, then, now Secret have the last pick here, and if they bank that they could be going against a Huskar Wisp here, what is your best choice to kind of help against the what could be potential 2-on-1?
I still think Secret need a way to take objectives. Like, Ursa can take Roche, but they can't really threaten towers at all right now.
So do you get, like, a tanky DK or something that could withstand a 2-on-1?
I got, like, Wind Ranger.
Pretty bad matchup,
Pugna,
though.
They go for the Morphling Shadow Demon combo.
All right. So, okay. Well, interesting. So that's their illusion hero, and that's a lot of physical damage burst, and they don't really have a single stun to actually kill Morphling, so
they also don't have really a good way to kill Weaver.
That's true.
Huskar, I would say. I guess Ursa might be okay, but not when there's a Dazzle and a Wisp.
All right. Predictions.
All right. Predictions. LJ on the end.
Secret Dire side with the Ursa. I'm not convinced about the Huskar pick. I think both Weaver and Morphling have a really good matchup this game, but I feel like Complexity are a little bit lacking in the five-man department. Elder Titan Tidehunter is going to run at you in the mid-game, and I'm favoring Secret.
Mr. Wu.
I think Complexity is a weaker team than Secret, and I would probably favor Secret regardless of the draft.
Okay.
For you, Fog.
What if they picked, like,
very straightforward.
Clowny?
I would have honestly favored Secret either way, but I do like the Morphing. I think he's going to be able to get a lot done, and I do think that Secret's overall draft has more synergy, even though Complexity does have a timing window that they can win.
Believe it or not, I'm going to believe in Complexity in this one, boys. So
again,
let's see if they can do it. We'll send it over to our casters now to let us in on all the hype action. It's those gentlemen on that side of the couch over there.
Thanks, Dakota.
Eldian.
Yeah, and you're not on the couch at all anymore. So, yep, Dakota will not be joining us, guys. But the game has begun. It's Secret versus Complexity. Game number two, Secret leading the series 1-0. Well, whenever we see a Huskar, Ben, the discussion tends to center around whether or not it's going to be one of those Huskars. Do you think he will take this game over?
I think a lot of times teams tend to fight into Huskar too much because he's like an overbearing presence in the early game, and I just generally don't think that's the appropriate response. You want to slow him down a lot, like draw out the game so that he doesn't snowball off hero kills. I think that's how the hero thrives. You go on him, he gets saved, he kills everyone because he's really low. I think the way around that is take objectives where he's not and farm way faster than him because he's not particularly fast at farming. You can get like an armlet, you can get an HOD, but you're not going to farm faster than a Morphling. You're not going to split push as hard as a Morphling. And I think that Secret will just take the approach of dodge, 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 and just kill their supports and then kill Huskar later into the game.
All right, well, with that, Arteezy starting off here. Looks like in the mid lane, they're going to be running the Morphling up top, with the Tidehunter off to the bottom side of the map. So it seems that Secret running the full defensive tri-lane here to get things underway. They have dropped a sentry, looking to ensure the pole camp, and they've also blocked the enemy Ancients, they haven't blocked off the Ancients. They've warded off the big camp, so they want to keep tabs here on the jungle Beastmaster, if indeed that is the way that Swindles opts to go. And Swindles, well, he said it before quite a few times, sometimes you just want to start Iron Talon, and this is exactly what he's doing. This is a deviation, though, from game number one. Meanwhile, Courier coming in mid.
That's a tough Courier kill. 350 moves behind
Puppy,
that thing.
Though, he's got the staple gun. Actually, Woo! This is more of a mallet. He's gonna club it. Gets it once, gets it twice, gets the courier kill.
Wow, that was...
Nobody expects the Elder Titan courier snipe.
Dang, he's fast. 360 moves feed? Yeah, I didn't expect that at all. Jeez.
That's pretty important in this matchup.
Yeah, because like two hits as a melee hero is like generally pretty difficult. If you're really quick with the courier, Michael, you just move it away as soon as you see him on the minimap, because it's daytime in the 0 to 3 minutes. But I just simply don't think they were expecting you. That's not something that you prepare for in the early game. If they really were scared, they would just skirted the chicken to the right side of the T1 and the T2.
I mean, it's not like they picked a Winter Wyvern here, someone who's known for his proficiency at the courier snipe. But unfortunately, Complexity, again, the laning stage not starting off too hot. Swindle's having a better time as he has begun Iron Talon jungling, but Bulba also doing the same. And then you've got a Morphling free farming, getting a lot more out of his lane so far than the Weaver. Only 6 CS to 14. He's getting lapped, and it's an empty lane bottom. Weaver does not have the easiest animation to last hit with, but off to a slow start here.
How's he up 15 already? Jeez. Is he, I guess it might be full agility too.
Yeah. I mean, definitely it's a harder to last hit as Weaver, but it's a pretty big discrepancy. Starts to close the gap a little, equalize things here. But both teams abandon the offlane bend, the courier getting sniped. Do you favor either team significantly here, numbers aside, as far as the way the lanes are developing?
I think Seeker's getting a lot more out of their safe lane. They dropped the sentry ward to ensure that their big camp wasn't blocked, and they were able to pull that a few times, and then Tidehunter also kind of has a free time, whereas, I think it's, like, far more generally just benefits Seeker, because Complexity has a Huskard, they need to make things happen with it. And
now, how worried are you about the fact that your Ursa is getting very little out of lane? He is being dual laned.
As long as he gets levels, he can do Roche at like level 5 with Morbid if he wants.
So you don't really care, basically.
It's as long as he doesn't die, I think he's fine. Which he shouldn't die to a Huskar Wisp lane. They don't have that much kill potential, although they will keep his farm from being out of control. But his farm's not even that bad. 7 CS is pretty decent, although they have had Puppy kind of in that area a lot. So now they see the Dazzle is going to be around there and leeching up top, so they might like set up for like a kill into a tower fairly soon because the catapult's about to spawn. So I'm not sure how they're going to prepare for that, but you don't want a Dazzle just free leeching that lane.
Yeah, they have really pummeled this top tier one Secret. Looking for the very early tier 1 takedown. Well, meanwhile, Chessy, unable to really get any sort of momentum bottom. He's just slightly chipping away, but doesn't really have that much damage to work with. So Bulba, now
he's level 4 already.
Lane. He's level 4. Swindle's pretty high up there as well, but watch out, Z-Freak. They're moving in on him. The difference, I guess, is it doesn't really feel like Swindles can easily stand in this lane with the combo that Secret have, whereas the Tide is not really afraid anymore, Ben, knowing the Io is going to be mid, and they don't have too much kill potential with just two. Certainly not with a Weaver.
Yeah, they're going to slow down the Weaver a lot.
Puppy looking for the stop rune. He goes for the stomp. He gets it on Z-Freak, as well as Handskin. Actually got the twofer, then snags the Invis rune right out from under their noses. Donnie rune spawning bottom. Cheeky play there by Puppy. Looks like Secret will get the double rune grab. He brings himself down to do it. So everything looking really good. Puppy controlling rune, sniping the courier. He is falling a bit behind in levels here.
That's okay. He's slowing down the Wisp, and in doing so, slows down the Huskar. If Wisp doesn't get a free bottle refill, then Huskar has a lot less sustain in lane, and this frees up some farm for Ursa. So they've actually sent Ursa to the jungle. Does he have a Quelling Blade, Iron Talon, anything of the sort? Looks like just a Quelling Blade, so just deciding that they want to leech experience. He was harassed a lot in the mid lane, and he wouldn't be getting anything out of it, especially as Burning Spears levels up.
Yeah, Bulba in turn will grab those raindrops, transitions to bottom. And he pokes his head out pretty confidently versus Chessy with Envy, holding serve in the top lane. See, Chessy look to move in for some Sakuchi harass, but yeah. I mean, again, look at the matchup. This is not favorable for Weaver.
Geminate attack not so good versus Kraken Shell, and Eternal Envy very good at pressuring the tower when there is no one there or very few people there, and this should be a free tower kill for him.
Yeah, pretty heavy on the agility. Envy will get the last hit, so Secret, the first courier snipe, the first tower, the lead as far as CS for the carry.
Oh,
now looking for Swindles
right
too.
That.
They want the first blood to add to their repertoire, and they're likely to find it now. Over the top, the waveform combination. They score a kill.
They even dropped the sentry to make sure that he was safe. But he, like, maybe he was like microing his hawk or something like that. But he saw the spirit and he backed off just like in the wrong direction. He walked towards the spirit instead of running immediately to the left, and just dies to a very easy setup. I mean, this is a level 6 Beastmaster too. He was number 2 in CS. He was doing fairly decently in terms of farming. He picked up his tranquils, but just being a little bit careless at that junction, and it's going to cost Complexity even more damage on their towers.
Yeah, things looking a bit grim for Complexity, even towards the tail end of the laning stage, but they do have the Huskar working towards the armlet, I imagine. He does have an Io and a Dazzle, so it is a Superman Huskar kind of game. Will he find the openings? Because at the rate the game's going, it feels like it will need to be the Huskar that takes over. Chessy not farming all that well.
It's not a one-man team, though. Single-core Huskar has been harped on many times for not being able to win games, and I think that this game is no different. Like, he needs other heroes to do things. He needs Beastmaster to smoke up and roar. He wasted his TP score trying to get out of the last one, so that's, you know, quite some bit of time until he can actually make a move. Weaver has been, like, her net worth compared to the Morphlings already, like, almost 2,000, so, like, sooner or later it might be, like, double up, the Morphling versus the Weaver, and then, like, Weaver can't do anything versus the Tidehunter in lane, so they're having like a lot of things to deal with right now, and like they also need stacks on the Wisp so that they can catch up in terms of levels. They need relocate online fairly soon. They need tomes. Like both their supports are hurting pretty badly.
Secret just playing the pure economy game at the Ursa, still jungling. I've seen the Elder Titan catch up at experience. Bulba also off in the woods. Envy holding the lane, a full 1200 gold advantage over the next closest hero in this matchup. And they are going to make a move here. They're trying to find Swindles. They get the disruption off. Poison coming through. Soulcatcher is there. The waveform not timed right by Envy, though. Won't actually connect, but still, the damage is almost enough with the stomp. The poison stacks coming through, the spirit in pursuit. One more poison. Oop, still running. And the long range wave for one more auto attack. Envy gets it done. But does he make it out is the question. Chessie on the chase, looking to get something back out of this. There are stick charges available. Envy isn't going to bother using them. And Chessie strikes back. So in the end, turns out to be a rather beautiful bait by Swindles. Now hunting for Pylai die. This looks to be a second kill. Slowed down by Z-Freak, moving into position. But again, that Elder Titan spirit saving the day. Well, Huskar ramps up mid, Chessie still chasing, going for the neutral deny. Is he gonna get it? Yes, he is. So Secret, unfortunate there.
That was very poorly played by Envy. Missing that waveform of the Soulcatcher Beastmaster cost him a lot. He also, I thought he was gonna try and toggle and then stick and then try and TP out or something like that, but he didn't quite have the HP because of the swarm ticking down on him.
Yeah, I guess Feg felt even if he sticked, he may have died anyway, but... Well, ends up costing them here as Limp moves in. They do have eyes on Arteezy. Has the phase boots, though. I don't know if they have the move speed or the vision to get that life break off. The Hawk is there, giving them a spot of vision in the neighborhood. They chase forward, looking for Arteezy, the courier.
They have no way to stop this TP.
And Arteezy moving fast. He doesn't have the mana just yet. Now he gets onto the courier. He goes for one auto attack. Then the dunk comes through. Arteezy will immolate.
How do they get vision there?
I think Hawk, I believe?
Yeah, the Hawk, yeah.
Or maybe the Courier.
That was nice. Without that Hawk vision, I don't think they would have gotten that kill. He wouldn't have been able to leap on him in time, so nice play by Swindles right there.
Well, that's two cores going down. Secret, just an immaculate laning Radiant stage here, but with that, the cores of complexity right back in it. The Weaver up there with the Morphling, the Huskar. Armlet online now. Yeah, it gets to become a factor.
That death from Morphling, though, super costly. Because he was so high in terms of net worth, too. He gave a lot to Chessie. He was 2,000 above, now he's only 600 above.
And they try to make more off of this. Complexity now smoking up, pushing the advantage. The Hawk's there. Perhaps trying to find Bulba here, who's about to complete his Ancient Stack. Unfortunately, all that remains is single Black Dragon.
And he's not even low.
But they have the Huskar in position. Limp moving in, gets the dunk off on Pylai. They're going to commit a Roar for that as well. And they will secure the kill. So while that was happening, unfortunately, Weaver goes down towards the top side of the map. So it ends up being a one for one, a support for a core. Secret likely to be happy with that. They still have the Ravage ready as well on the stomp. Onto Z-Freak will end up connecting. Now they look to follow it up. Arteezy laying into him, gets off the self-grave. Are they going to commit a Ravage for this? He doesn't want the kill that bad. Let's him go. It seems like they want to save that Ravage for potential Roshan.
I think it would have been okay for him to commit there, but I like Puppy sweeping in a little bit early too, because he knows that they're going to try and ward up the Ancients, and he like went on the Dazzle immediately, tried to scout him out even before Complexity had cleared the area. So like getting extra intel there is very important so they can secure their Ancient farm and keep Tidehunter relevant.
Disruption was used, Soulcatcher didn't connect, but still the follow-up. And they, in the end, won't pursue further. Envy here, meanwhile, in the neighborhood top lane, he does toggle on the strength more. Looks like he's trying to bait Chessie to overcommit. Has the waveform ready for round two. Could potentially find a kill there on the Weaver if he's not careful. And you can see the Weaver just very lacking in the damage department at this stage. Needs some help to make things happen, but doesn't get it just yet. Has grabbed the Blightstone, gone back to the Ring of Health.
How's the Ursa's items? We haven't seen him in a little bit, ever since he started moving the jungle.
Has phase boots,
they have a Morbid?
I imagine Morbid Mask at this point. No.
Yeah, he doesn't have Morbid yet.
1300. What's he saving for here?
I'm not sure. That's what I was wondering. Like, if they want to do Roshi, we could just get a blink right now. Straight blink is good if they want to kill the Wisp.
Can they Roche without the Morbid Mask, or is this just a tell that they likely don't want
You can do it with a Replicate Illusion, tanking it. That's actually not that bad of an option for them, so maybe Morbid isn't completely necessary for them. I think they could maybe do it if Tidehunter had a mech too, but I
think he's close. He had the buckler and the headdress and like 400 gold previously.
I don't think you want your Tidehunter there. Like you want him like outside of the pit. You also want him like pressuring out lane so that you can see more complexity heroes out on the map. If he's inside the Roche pit, I think you lose out on a lot of information.
Secret R pressuring here in the bottom side of the map. Three heroes grouped up. Limp holding the mid lane for now, but they are going to make their way forward. Bulba really bullying anybody who might be in the neighborhood away.
See, if they can go with this tower, I think that's going to be Roche. And like Huskar is pretty Roche dependent too. He also has a Helm of Dominator, so he can actually do it quite early on, although maybe not versus an Elder Titan. So I'm surprised that they're putting up so little resistance to this bottom T1 tower.
It seems they just don't want to fight into the Ravage mech and range.
You have a Huskar though, like I think you always want to fight with a Huskar, especially because Wisp is level 6 right now, so I don't really think they should be that scared, but Dire has used scan. Boom.
Hostiles incoming.
Yeah, I think it looks like maybe Puppy had made that scan, because he's the one that TP'd immediately up after. So yeah, free tower. I don't think the T2 matters that much. Just because with Huskar, you still want to take fights. Like, objectives are kind of important, but this T2 doesn't really matter in the Roche contention, whereas the bottom T1 does a lot more.
Well, tower down, and Limp continues to move in, but Puppy there, looking for the stomp. Slow things down. We talked last game about the lack
Ursa's,
of deep push.
Ursa's going somewhere. Did he buy anything yet? Still hasn't bought anything?
I guess he must be getting blink.
Seems that way. It's a very curious build. You usually don't see that.
So just for the IO, you think?
I think so. He can also pick off the... I don't think he can do it up damage.
Oh, you know what? Is there any chance of like a Silver Edge rush here? Just to do with the Huskar?
Yeah, he has a blink already.
Okay, he bought the blink.
I think the natural order helps like decent amount versus the Huskar too.
Oh, Puppy's out a bit far. Looks like the Elder Titan will get caught out. They commit the roar for this.
See, immediately they ping out
follow up, dunk, and dead.
Do you see them? They as soon as they saw Puppy out there, they ping out a road. I think they actually wanted this to happen.
He's like, I'm gonna go die top, and then we're gonna take rush.
So now he doesn't even need the mask. With
Weaver's
the
moving in. They do have relocate. They will be lacking the roar though.
Yeah, but they're gonna fight in a Ravage. You don't relocate on a Ravage.
And the mech.
Yeah. That's.
And it's already too late.
That was a bait by Secret.
So tempting though.
Yeah, it's an Elder Titan. With the Huskar though, you want the Roche. That's higher priority. Like, Elder Titan's kill is kind of inconsequential. Yeah, I think he actually, like, probably ends up net positive on gold because of that experience. He's only level 9. He's only losing a couple hundred gold, and then you get the Roche.
So Secret still, with a slight advantage here as far as net worth goes. Huskar pretty much in his prime at this point, but now has to fight his way through an Aegis if he wants to engage. Does grab the Talisman.
I think that overall, the Complexity are controlling the wrong part of the map. They want to control the Dire jungle and the Dire top, but I think they should have focused more on the Dire T1 on bottom and the Ancient
on the Roche
area. Yeah, because that's where they smoked to earlier. They got the smoke, they got one kill, and then they lost control of it, even though they want to fight there. And then Secret have kind of always been having heroes in that area. They dewarded it. They're very protective of that area, knowing that a lot of this game is bared on the Roche, whereas Complexity, they just kind of left that area. They're like, we don't really care. We're still farming, but... But like the objectives are so much more important for Secret, even though it looks like the tower count is in Complexity favor. They've taken down two T1s and a T2 as opposed to three T1s, but Secret, they got Roche super easily. There wasn't even a fight there.
Well, and so much of that just comes down to this tier 1 bottom still being up at the 60-minute mark running a Huskar. Something that we've seen a lot of teams will prioritize, just taking all those tier 1s down right away.
Yeah, so now they have to play the farm game. Chessie, I'm just actually getting there in terms of farm Dragonlance, plus Lincoln's in the process. But Morphling is very annoying, and no long duration silence, so...
And like, has the Lincoln, so you can't roar him now. They actually have no disables.
Yep, and no one's going to build an Orchid, no one's going to build a Scythe. So, their
so
best...
what do you do? Wait, do you just ignore the Morphling?
That's
for now.
Always sounds like a terrible idea, but I think they have to. You can wait for him to make a mistake like he did on the left side T2, but...
But he did that without a Lincoln's and a lot squishier.
Yeah, you can wait for him to get mana burned down. That's probably the best bet.
Here's Bulba, Blink Ravage and a quick waveform.
They're smoked too, I think. They're smoked as well.
But do they want to fight minus the Weaver? There is no Ravage either. That could allow the Huskar to run rampant in these upcoming engagements. Bulba there.
He's out on the ground. Front.
That watermelon has no fear. He's confidently strutting up and down.
He's playing a lot better in the last game. Notice he's like out in front a lot. He's like protecting his supports and his carries a lot more. I think for some reason he got a little bit too far behind last game, but this game he's, you know, just been in the right place at the right time. He was there protecting that Roche and just always been sticking around the very important parts.
Oh, here comes the roar. Isolating Pylai die. Does get the Necro Bulk out. Swindle's looking for a quick takedown here, but the lane is pushing against them bottom. So it doesn't look like this will even lead to a tower unless they just want to straight backdoor it.
That was poor gold management by Pi. He knew he was dead. He had 2.5 seconds to disrupt. He could have spot like a pair of sentries or something without really any loss there. But not too big of a deal for them. But finally, Complexity will get the T1 tower. And
they know the Ravage is down. We've got 85 seconds to work with here. So tier 1 will fall. Creep wave just now. Being finished off all the way back at the tier 2.
But they're trying to push into Elder Titan, and you're gonna get objectives, but it's gonna be like pretty slow. And
no more Necro Book now.
Do they have any creeps?
No, the lane's just slowly pushing.
Yeah, they don't have any creeps, so like.
they'll have like, what, like one wave here before the Ravage is up?
Eternal Enemy's about to take down your T2. He can even like send an Astral Spirit to stomp the next wave, and they have to wait like another 5 seconds, and then Stomp will be up by the time it gets to the T2 again. So that's just kind of very inefficient.
Oh, Envy's going in. Swindles, he's not done the math properly here, and Envy will punish him for it.
What on earth was that?
3,500 gold now.
Fog, explain to me. Fog laughing.
Fog does flummox.
Yeah, that is Envy, a flummoxing play.
Envy is anything but. He is confident, he is sieging, and he's out of there. So he'll jump down into the river. Playing a bit with fire, because Limp was in the neighborhood. But
notice how well they're playing around the Huskar. Like, when has Huskar been able to jump someone, aside from killing Arteezy when he was at the T2? Like, he hasn't been involved in fights at all. They're just completely playing a void on the Huskar and taking down Roche, taking down towers in the process, and Morphling is getting further and further ahead in net worth.
And it's not like it's going to change anytime soon. The Morphling's only going to get harder to kill and have more kill potential of his own.
If he messes up somehow, then yeah, but...
And Arteezy will debut as Blink, gets the bash, no self-grave available. It's been a very quiet game from the Ursa, but he's done what he's needed to. He's helped the team take Roshan. He now starts to flex his muscles a little more, moving actively around the map.
It's cool that he doesn't know lifesteal build, though, which is very rare because it's hard to take like ancients and stuff and keep yourself topped off. So I'm not actually sure how he's like keeping his HP topped off all the time, but that's...
Have we seen a relocate yet this game?
Nope.
I don't think so, right?
I don't believe so.
20 minutes in. Complexity just hasn't really... You mentioned Huskar's not fighting. Io isn't relocating. They just don't have anyone really making plays around the map. But we've seen Swindles occasionally go for a roar kill, but it's always the support.
Yeah.
Top lane when they got Elder Titan, it led to a Roshan. Killing the Shadow Demon, that was just an a la carte Shadow Demon and a tier 1. They're just not getting enough out of the picks.
It's like the hard to kill heroes on Secret are usually showing, aside from the one Shadow Demon kill on bottom, but like most of the time it's like the hero that you like you see are like, oh, we can't kill him, and that's like the Ursa with the Aegis and the Blink, and then like Bulba with the Ravage and Blink and Greaves. Like these are just heroes that you just want to avoid too, similar to how Secret are just not interested in seeing Huskar.
And he will reveal himself mid. Seems like the Dazzle's moving in. They are trying to jump him up top, it looks like. Will they be able to find him? Envy on the run still. They relocated for this as well. They do have, I think, a dunk available, and they'll let it go. Envy gets brought down. Complexity able to combine there and find the kill. So it's a Morphling for an Io. They'll take that trade any day of the week.
Fog is flummoxed again. And ET's already there. Like, Puppy is so quick about how he, like, defends against these pushes. And I think they still have the Aegis up on the Ursa if they want to take this fight, but...
Oh, Complexity on the siege! This is what the Doctor ordered! Oh, a very preemptive grave there. Complexity not communicating. Had the time-lapse and the grave pop the boat. Now Limp's got to play more carefully. They may have to retreat. There is a buyback on this Morphling, though. They may not realize it. Sticking around could be costly with the Ravage still available. They'll have to stop.
Man, pushing against ET is so ridiculous. Like, they got a super important kill. Eternal Envy right outside of the T3. Yet they
with
don't
the
even
creep
get
wave coming as well, but yeah. Then nothing.
They got 75% of the T3, so that's pretty good. But I don't know if they're going to be given another opportunity like that. Envy with his
never doubt check.
Yeah.
For good plays and for questionable.
Yeah. Just to have replicate ready in case of situations like that. But I don't think I expected like 5 people to be there with a relocate.
Well, I mean, it felt like that's what Complexity needed, though. They have to take some risks this game. They have to go for unconventional pickoffs. They can't just, you know, expect someone to walk right into the Beastmaster with the Huskar already there. Unfortunately, Benvy doesn't make those mistakes moving forward, and he is about to get a Manta style. So he's going to become even more elusive, better at baiting out single target spells potentially, and harder to kill. Not opting for the shotgun build this game. Do you like the Manta here, Ben? Is there something else you would have considered?
He just needs a split push and just delay the game and keep increasing his net worth difference.
So what do we get? Butterfly, like Scotty next,
I think that's fine.
The right click item.
If you're really scared, you can go BKB, but I don't agree with that because there's a lot of physical damage. I much prefer Butterfly over BKB. But
well, they can slow the push when it comes to the high ground siege, but Complexity are bringing towers down.
Yeah, they're getting a lot of objectives. The T2 top, T2 mid, and looks like Roche.
Here comes the Shadow Demon army.
This is scary.
That's a lot of Morphlings. And Pilot Eye is already back mid to assist the team.
The water
comes in a deluge here in the bottom lane, and Complexity will have to back and deal with this. They'll TP home one. Huskar's out, the rest of the team scrambling the retreat, already the Elder Titan, oh, it swindles down in the river on his lonesome, and Secret will punish. So they force them back, they do not retreat carefully as a squad, and they cost themselves a Beastmaster kill, and conveniently for Secret, Roshan coming up soon, but doesn't seem quite soon enough, about a minute to go here before the big rock respawns.
Secret are one unified unit when it comes to Roshan, like, they wait for Eternal Envy to draw a hero to TP back. As soon as that happens, all four of them sweep into the Roche pit, just immediately aggressively blink, knowing that it's going to be a 4-on-5 or 4-on-4 with Ravage. And then if they get a kill, it's going to be an easy Roche. And Secret now are extending that territory, and Complexity just struck at some at the wrong time. But even if they, like, even if Roche were up like a minute earlier, Complexity can't walk into there and do it.
Radiant's middle tower. I guess the good news for Complexity, Roche was not up, but now he is, so one more mistake like that will cost them the Aegis, will likely lead to Secret at least chipping at some of these tier 3 towers.
Complexity, they need to fight this, though. I think they're grouped up for smoke, and
oh,
this could be a big...
He's on front, but he has the Blink Dagger. He's
he has no buyback. This could be dangerous.
Creep out in front, trying to scout from the Spirit, walks through. Limp, and now Complexity all the way into the pit, but Secret have already backed away. And they're going to go for the counter smoke. Who's going to be out in front this time? Spirit finally returning to the Elder Titan. Complexity breaching high ground as they move towards the Dire Tier 2. Swindles out in front.
Where's his replicate?
Trotting towards bottom. And trying to get the jump off here. He blinks, he roars. It's onto Puppy. He connects, but Bulba's there in reserve. The disruption immediately comes out. Good position for Pilot Eye. So Roar committed. Nothing yet gained. This Complexity venture in deeper. Ursa blinking forward. Somebody eats out that Shadow Demon. Nobody's doing it. They'll lose him off the bat, but Limp goes hard in the back lines. Does manage to bring down the other Titan finally. And Chessy isolates Pilot Eye. Lacking the disruption. Just now cooled down, but it's too late. Complexity delete both supports, but while that's happening, Envy is in the base, just outmaneuvering them. The dunk is shrugged off, and Envy tries to man fight this Huskar. That ain't gonna happen. He'll have to back away. Quickly, Strength morphs his way out, but strategically, Secret coming out on top there with the range racks now exposed, brought down to a quarter HP. Roshan unlikely to be taken now, perhaps with the relocate back. They might go for this one.
Yep.
But
they definitely
supports,
should.
Supports will be back, but there will not be a Ravage. So Complexity looking to make the correct counterplay here.
And two extremely heroes, hard heroes to fight against. Even the ET and the Shadow Demon are both very good in the Roche pit, but yep, too much damage, nice relocate coming out.
That stomp a bit too late, the blink in also late from Bulba. He may end up costing himself his life here, he's gone in too far. Limp is dunking after him, he's gonna lock him down, but Huskar getting controlled for now by the Ursa. The ultimate's gonna wear off though, and Limp hasn't died just yet. Envy into the pit as well, he wants to fight, he wants to rumble a bit too. They can't bring down Handskin, he survives the IO, hanging on. Complexity, by a thread they stand, but Well, they are low here on the IO, on the Huskar. They have to back away. They did lose their Beastmaster, so they traded the two offlaners. They grabbed the Aegis successfully, and they didn't actually lose a Rax yet.
Nice prioritization by Complexity.
I think Complexity will be quite happy with that.
Yeah, very nice from them. I think they can actually beat on high ground. I don't know if they want the game to go that much longer because of the Morphling being able to split push. Like, the top lane of Rax are exposed, and they're not going to have that many more opportunities to actually take a fight here. Ravage is still down for a little bit of time. Eternal Envy, no replicate up, but it looks like he's already trying to threaten that Rax.
Well, TP'd on top, and I think has second thoughts and backs away.
But he can creep skip if he really wants to.
This really feels like the Envy of old, with the complete dedication to split push, very little interest in fighting.
He's walking in a couple heroes here.
Well, he moves forward. Waveform off the mark, though. Z-Freak with the instant self-grave. And they are still pursuing this. The Swarm is deployed, and Envy gonna quickly Manta, but Chessie's working on him. He will have to back out, trying to be the bold frontliner for Secret. It slows down the offensive, so he drags them all back. He makes it away safely, but Complexity march forward again. They're leading with the Weaver here. Puppy going for the stomp. Envy being disrupted, creates the replicate now. Looks to head home. So the Morphling Illusion Swarm strat continues.
Micro the Illusions, Pilot Eye. Those do a lot of damage.
Yeah, could almost kill Hanskin if they got off their full volley of auto attacks.
It's not like regular illusions. And with the BOTs, the split push threat will be compounded. As Envy looks to be super annoying, but because he's not a base, maybe a little bit more difficult. Actually, they can just use SD disruption on the replicate and just send it at like the weak supports. So now they have to do something about this.
I mean, this is clearly the death by a thousand cut strat from Secret. How do you respond at this point if you're Complexity?
Find some way to force high ground. They need to pick off close when there's a creep wave close to the base when the Aegis is up. But that requires, I think, a mistake from Secret's part or a really timely smoke and or really good wards by Complexity. They do have that really nice ward in between the T3s on the top and the mid lane, and this will probably provide the opening that they're looking for to siege high ground. They really don't have that much time left, though, because Aegis is not on an infinite timer.
Well, Limp has a couple of other extra lives here to work with, has picked up the Satanic, also has the Solar Crest now. No MKBs or evasion piercing here as of yet, but they do find Swindle. He's out on his own. He needs some help. The Ravage comes through. It's going to interrupt the dunk by Limp. Grave committed there. Tries to keep Swindles in fighting shape for the time being. And the Huskar, well, for the time, moves forward onto Arteezy, getting shut down as his ultimate ends. They will bring down the Ursa. Has the buyback ready. Nobody pushing right now for Team Secret. They've come home. Hanskin almost dead. The stomp is going to not even be required. Just the spirit alone. Puppy will bring him down. Uses the Ghost Scepter to try to get back towards safety. A volley of auto attacks there from the Weaver. Not enough to find the kill, so it ends up being two supports down. Huskar will live, but this is a carry that relies more than others on his supports in most cases.
He has a Satanic,
has
too.
The Satanic, has the Aegis. There is a buyback on IO. Could try to bait here and then buyback, relocate in, and look for a big play. Ravage is down. Complexity feel this is the time to strike. They continue the siege, bringing down the creep wave, moving forward onto the tier 3 tower. Disruption, though, by Pi. Slows it down. Huskar Illusions, very tanky.
They have such good ways to delay.
The stall is there, and now Envy is split push. He's brought down the Ranger X top. He's working on the melee. Swindles, no way to stop this. Envy just strength morphing up a bit. He's going to wave off to the left into the trees and TP's his way out of there. So he gets a lane of Rax out of this maneuver. Complexity are just getting completely outcircled as the game moves along.
Yeah, split push to death. We haven't seen this really too much in a while, but it's definitely a very good way to handle the Huskar, and I think Eternal Envy has been playing well despite that one costly death on that top lane. He actually almost died in the last fight. Did you see how low he dropped?
Yeah, I mean, strategically, it feels like a really solid game plan by Secret, where you mentioned earlier they dodge the fights with the Huskar, they stall with the Elder Titan and the Shadow Demon's ability to deep push. When they have to take Roshan fights, they do so with the Ursa to steal it quickly, and or the Tide to secure the team fight, and then they just rely on the Morphling Shadow Demon split push to try and take objectives. So, while the execution hasn't always been perfect, the strategy has been sound. So you see Swindles there almost dying to the Morphling Replicate. Secret move down mid. But Complexity straight through the mid lane. At some point, we may just see them commit heavily for this push.
Huskar is not the fastest tower seizer, too. Although they do have Inner Beast, but, like, look at this stall. That is... That's like 5 seconds where they aren't hitting tower, and that's 5 seconds more that Secret is going to be able to beat on this T3, and looks like Complexity are not interested in defending.
Oh, they're committing for this one. Tier 3 going to drop. What do they go for after that? They've got the Dental on Chessy. The Glyph comes out, but it's right as the tower drops. Meanwhile, bottom lane, though, Secret finding the pickoff. Swindle's down. Now working on the Range Rex Arteezy. He wants a piece of the melee Complexity. Some heroes starting to come home, but Limp is being controlled for now. Chessy chipping away. The mid rack slowly dropping. Limp not dead just yet. Getting ready to jam, perhaps. He's got the dunk, he's not using it. He's focusing on structures, turning back. Oh, and he does go to the south side. But still, the rack's not dead, and Envy already. He's caved in this bottom lane quite a bit here. They are chasing forward. The Ravage comes through, dump the handskin to turn this fight around. Tether comes out, has the relocate available, not opting to use it just yet. He's counting on Lip to build a man mode his way through this one. Finally, will bring him back. And they'll have to reset here, but again, Secret, they're taking buildings. Even if you get the kills, who really cares? And Hanskin now will return, accepts his fate, insta-bash the Diffusal Blade, quickly removing that Ghost Scepter.
I mean, this is one of the reasons why ET is like a top-tier support. Like, the amount of time that he created alone while being super safe from the threat of Complexity killing him is just absurd. He probably stopped, like, combined in between Huskar and Weaver, like, 20 seconds, I would say, on the tower beating, which was more than enough time for Secret to take down the full racks on bot. I think Secret were actually, like, further away from the T3 than Complexity was when they were both marching towards that oh-so-coveted racks, but, man, the stall tactics. And
it's got to be frustrating if you're Complexity.
It really is.
Mentally, this is an exhausting game already, and this is before Envy gets 6-7 slotted.
But now they only have one Rex left, and the T2 is also just recently died. And then if you want to take a big team fight, you don't have the Aegis right now. You're going to have to deal with two Ravages on Bulba, and perhaps even an Aegis and Cheese if Secret can get their hands on this next Aegis. And then your supports are going to die because Ursa is always in the back lines, defusaling, bashing the Dazzle so that he can't grave the Huskar. And then sooner or later, they're going to be able to kill the Wisp. So I think like they have to do a really good job of protecting the supports. They, like, kite the Ursa during his enrage. Make sure Dazzle doesn't drop quickly so you can keep on supporting the Wisp, who can support the Huskar. So all your
but they have to fall. They have to do this also while not just getting Mega.
Yeah. It's and of
winning
course,
winning the fight is already a delicate dance. Let alone doing so without losing structures.
And then on top of that, they have to worry about not getting like 3 or 4 man Ravage by a Blink Dagger Tidehunter and not getting stomped into a Ravage.
It sure looks bleak for Complexity at this point. Is there an all-in play?
I think that was close to an all-in play
I thought they were considering like going straight for the throne or something.
You can't. Huskar just can't hit towers. But you know what changes that?
If Burning Spears worked on buildings?
Nope. If he gets a rapier.
Okay. Yeah. If he can farm a rapier, that's probably the bigger issue.
He hasn't even been able to hit heroes, though. Like,
I'm sure the Huskar hero damage this game is
very low.
Below the 50th percentile by a long shot.
And Secret, again, controlling the Roshan area. Complexity, they might be able to threaten top, but Eternal Envy already in the mid lane, threatening that last set of racks. And they're going to have to split up their heroes already. They do have Relocate available to them, so they can be as 5, but if they misplay right here, or they teleport into a double Ravage, it could be GG.
A lot of ifs. Secret looking for certainty here is the Radiant Courier will get killed off, but more importantly, they're looking for the hero grabs, and for some reason, it always seems to be Swindle's the one who gets spotted out first, but this time, he's able to blink away. Let's drop the Necro Bulk. There's the Ravage, though. Ravage number 1 connects on 3. Ravage number 2, also on 3. Locking down the Huskar, but not finishing him off, and he's going to look for the jump forward. No disruption prevents that on the backside. Arteezy gets to work trying to bring down Swindles. Where's Envy? Oh, he's deep. He's on Z-Freak. He brings it down. He focuses on the tower. It's all about the buildings here for Team Secret. Artur with his dying breath. We'll get one last swipe of those paws off. They hold the line for now, Complexity, but they had to buy back on the Dazzle here. Secret of all the lanes pushing in their favor, aside from that top lane.
I think they should buy back on Ursa, because I think that Complexity are going to try and head a rush and I think end the game with that finishing blow. But if they do not have a Ravage, so this is actually going to be a very difficult fight for them.
They're moving forward here. They want a piece of Eternal Envy. Hanskin Does manage to get off the Ghost Scepter as they chase a little bit deeper. Envy into the trees. He's going to play it safe. Oh, or is he?
He was trying to BOT to bottom, I think. Because I saw him, like, face bottom, not face.
Creep may have died there, so instead, just replicate out.
But, yeah, I think this might be the all-in play.
But he has no BOTs now. Is he going to run home, or is Envy going all in his own right? Complexi say screw the Roshan. We're going for it. Diving deep onto Bulba. All of a sudden, there's no Ravages available. There's no Morphling at home.
No Ursa.
Does he come back? Envy, he is working on the Mega Creeps, but Limp's committing here to Tier 4 Tower. Secret somehow have found themselves in a very dangerous base race, but they are going to commit for it. Envy, just the melee racks, not a drop, and then we'll have the BOTs ready in a couple of seconds. The Glyph has been committed, though, and Limp is going for structures here. Does Envy come home? Is he coming back, or is it all in? Bulba sticking around, but he's basically just a big creep at this point. Envy's going to, or Arteezy rather, is going to get junked, focused down by Complexity. Creeps are starting to hit on the Tier 4 Towers. Bulba getting gunned down from distance by Limp. He too will fall, and finally Envy comes back, but he comes back lacking a couple of teammates. They will double buyback here on the Tidehunter, on the Ursa. Limp standing his ground, but he gets stopped, controlled, he's dead. They need that Huskar. They're gonna have to relocate him back into the fight if possible to get back in this game. Chessy now, Limp just BOTing and charging forward, but while that's happening, they lose him as well. They've lost the Beastmaster, the bug gets squashed. Huskar has bought back, but he's lacking a team to assist. The rest of the team will soon join him, but Envy's managed to find the Mega Creeps. That might be the killing blow.
That was a really nice attempt by Complexity there. They really made Secret sweat. Throne is at like half HP right now. They don't have the buyback yet on Ursa. They don't have the buyback on Elder Titan. They don't have the buyback on Tidehunter.
And now they have one Ravage, soon to be two.
And like they're fighting against Mega Creeps.
Yes. And they don't even have good wave clear.
But that was a very admirable attempt at ending the game. That was...
Well, they're going to commit for this one. They're just diving forward. The dunk on the Pilot Eye in the mid lane, but Creep pushing top and bottom. And Secret eviscerate the opposition. The Ravages come flying out from Bulba. And Secret will take it 2-0. There's no buybacks left. Swindle's the last man standing. Limps away. But his true friend Limp is already dead. They march down mid. They'll end this game. Secret looking solid here.
Very valiant number one by Complexity.
They didn't get to play with Huskar. They didn't have lockdown to prevent the Morphling from split pushing. The supports felt very underwhelming as far as their net worth and playmaking potential. And
it was just so hard for them to siege towers. Like, they couldn't hit towers as fast as Secret. And they, I think, like, maybe they thought they could match the mobility a little bit with, like, the